Good soup. Good soup.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Okay, good morning. Welcome back. If you are new here, my name is Michaela. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. So I figured I would take you through a killer humpity dumpity, roasty toasty dump truck workout today because I have a good one on the menu. Why are you meowing?
You're such a little flirt.
So yeah, we're gonna be doing a banging dump truck workout today. And I figured I would just take you through my morning routine. I don't have all my stuff here. So my initial plan was I was going to show you all of the supplements that I've been taking and using, as well as I wanted to do a Gymshark favorites video, but none of... Why? Anyways, so yeah, my initial plan was I wanted to show you all of the supplements that I take, but my second box from PE Science is not here yet, so I can only show you partially what I've been using. So I'll show you like my pre-workout session, and then I also wanted to show you the skincare products I've been using and loving, and yeah, so all that good stuff. I think for breakfast today, we are just gonna make some plain Jane oats. Oh, the sun is coming in. Lovely. I think I'm gonna do skincare first. Yeah, let's do skincare first. Okay, so I have been loving a lot of different products. I've been trying out a lot of different products. Some skincare products that I've been using, I can't actually show you yet because I'm still using and I'm testing them out, and then I will show you later if I end up liking them. So I typically don't wash my face in the morning. I used to do it all the time, but I ended up stopping because I just don't want to get rid of all the natural oils on my face, you know what I mean? If you have dry skin, you will understand. If you have oily skin, I will never understand you, and I do wish that I was you. So what I'll do in the morning instead of washing my face is I will take the Paula's Choice 2% BHA liquid exfoliant salicylic acid, and I will just put this on a cotton pad. So there's like a rough side and then there's like a soft side, and I will typically use the rough side on my face. So it's kind of like a toner, but it's not. I just felt like a toner was kind of a waste of a step for me. First of all, it was really hard for me to find a good one, and second of all, it was really hard for me to find a toner that didn't dry my skin out more than it already was. So I just stick to like a salicylic acid exfoliant, and I really like this one. It doesn't dry me out. It will dry you out if you use it very often. I use this like every second day. Next thing I'll use is the anti-redness exfoliating solution by Paula's Choice, 2% salicylic acid. I'm telling you, these two products together have literally saved my life, saved my acne prone skin. I do not know where I'd be without these. And I use these day and night, so not this one, this one every second day. And then, so this is extra strength 2%. If you have sensitive skin, I'd recommend going with the 1 or 1.5%. This will dry you out. Okay, that was a lot. You just gotta stay on top of your moisturizing routine, but I will just put it on my face. Okay, my camera focuses in and out all the time, so I'm looking into getting a new one because I can't deal with this. I really can't. It's so frustrating. I know some people mentioned on my last video how the autofocus was really annoying, and I completely agree. It's very, very annoying. Once I've done that, I will go in with a vitamin C serum. This is like my favorite part. I love vitamin C serum. Okay, so I have the ethylated ascorbic acid 15% solution by The Ordinary. So this is like a acting form of vitamin C. I don't think it's a direct form. Apparently there's more vitamin C in it. I don't really know, but was told that it's really good for like brightening and whatnot. And then I also have the Tula Brightening Treatment Drops Triple Vitamin C Serum. I really like these. I'm almost out actually, and I think I might repurchase. Something about putting vitamin C on my face, you know, makes me feel so good. If you like to wash your face in the morning, I used to use the probiotic and superfood cult classic purifying face cleanser by Tula, and this one smells so good. I can't say this is a go-to cleanser for me. To be honest, like if I'm gonna use a cleanser, I will just use my CeraVe Foaming Facial Cleanser. This has been the only cleanser that hasn't broken me out that I've actually felt like has gotten my face clean. Not to mention there's no scent. I can't really put any oil-based containing products on my face. It really clogs up my pores. But if you are really stuck on ingredients lists, I would totally do your research, first of all. But this one has a really clean, condensed ingredients list. So I just really like this one. There's no scent. It's never broken me out. So yeah, I'm honestly not too sure about this cleanser. Like I'm still kind of testing it out, but like I said, I just don't really wash my face in the morning. Moving on. Okay, so I do not typically use eye cream. From my research and what I've learned, they don't do much, but I've had this one for like 6 months, so I'm kind of trying to just use it up, and it is just the Origins Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream Brightening and Depuff. As you can see, I have quite a bit left, so I might as well just use it, you know? I wouldn't want it to go to waste. This is like $40 too. Like what is wrong with me? We have a lot of steps to our skincare routine up in here, okay? So next thing I do is I'll moisturize, and I like to just take a little bit of water and I'll literally like splash it on my face. It just helps your moisturizer absorb into your skin. And I'll just go in with the Hyaluronic Acid by The Ordinary, and I will just put it on my skin while it's damp, and then I'll immediately go in with the moisturizer. So I'm just using the Firming Ultra Repair Collagen Cream by First Aid Beauty, and you can't really see what it looks like, but I'm almost out, and I'm gonna be honest, I think I really love this one. Like, I've never had issues with it. It's never broken me out. The smell is just very subtle and clean. Like, it doesn't have, like, a crazy scent to it. So if you're like me and you try to stay away from scented products, out of all of the moisturizers I've tried, I think this one's pretty good. The final step and the most important, if you are not using sunscreen by now, sister, girl, I don't think I can stress anything more in a skincare routine than sunscreen. 365 days a year, I use sunscreen every single day. So this one is the MD Solar Sciences Daily Perfecting Moisturizer. I do actually have a code with this one, but I'm not sure what it is. I think it's just Michaela. This one, I absolutely love it. There's no shine. It works as a moisturizer. It's perfect for winter. It's SPF 30. This is one of the only good mineral sunscreens I found that doesn't leave a cast on my face. It's all like very natural, and oh my God, it is amazing. I'm not gonna lie to you, like, I love it. Another sunscreen I am obsessed with is the Ultra Light Daily Hydrating Fluid, and it is SPF 30, and it is a mineral sunscreen. I really like this one because it's very, very thin. So this one also does not leave a white cast. If you have oily skin, I feel like you might like this one because it is so thin. It just melts right into your skin. For my dry skin, this is like a reapplying sunscreen for me. So if I'm out in the sun all day, I like to just bring this one with me to reapply it. Whereas the first one I put on by MD Solar, it is very thick. Okay, so now we are just gonna deal with my hair. We're just going to the gym, so I think I'll probably just brush her out. I don't really have much to do today. I just have to go to the gym, come back and study because we are in final season. Okay, so one, my camera died, and two, the bathroom lighting just really was not doing it for me. So we're just gonna do our makeup Oh, here. When I go to the gym, I honestly don't do much. Like, I just put a little bit of tinted moisturizer on my face. So I'm just using the Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue Tinted Hydrating Gel Cream, and I'm mixing it with the True Match Lumi Glotion Drops by L'Oreal. I've been using this for like 3 years now. I just mix them together. I like the Lumi Glotion Drops just because it gives you some glow. And then I'll just use like a little tiny bit of the Bare Minerals. Like, that is literally all I use. And I will just mix it. Brittany just texted me. Brett is also coming home today, and I'm excited because he's been gone for a couple of days. I'm really breaking out around my mouth from my mask. He went to his hometown for a couple of days, so Zeus and I got to just hang out here and chill. Since I have a little bit of acne around my mouth, I like to use a beauty blender to blend it in so I'm not touching it with my hands. And yeah, this is literally, you guys, like, I'm not joking, before the gym, like, this is all I do. If I'm like really trying to get ready, I do have a video on that. I think it was like my first ever video. You can watch that if you want to see like an actual full face for me. But to be honest, like, when I'm busy and I'm running around like with school and I'm doing errands and I just like, I really don't have time to get ready in the mornings, this is all I do because it takes me like 2 seconds. Mother Nature has also been crushing me this week, and she's blessed me with tons of acne. Oh, just kidding. I think Brett is staying another night now. You know what? That's fine. I think I am gonna put a little bit of bronzer on just because I'm looking a little sad. We're gonna do a little bit of bronzer. Little bit of bronzer. Sometimes I'll put bronzer on, like, if I tan my skin and I find that my face is much whiter than my body, I'll put on a little bit of bronzer. I am not being precise at all. It's just a little quickity-doo, make-a-roo. Does that even make sense? I don't know. Anyways, that is all I really do. Gonna make like a big breakfast, but I'm just not really into it. Or maybe I am. Do I want eggs? Maybe I'll do oats and eggs. I was gonna do oats and then mix my protein with it, but I'm thinking that I want just plain Jane oats with eggs today. But anyways, if I am mixing my protein in, I will use the Select Protein. I have the chocolate cupcake or the snickerdoodle. I do have a code with PE Science. It is Michaela with 2 A's at the end if you want to support me and save some money. I actually couldn't have whey protein for the longest time, and PE Science is the only whey protein that I seem to be able to tolerate. So gym fit today. I think I'm gonna wear my green camo seamless leggings from Gymshark, and then my Set Active. Seriously, you're ruining it. My Set Active bra. I'm wearing the brown one right now, and then Gymshark socks and my dirty white Nikes that need to be washed, right? Okay, so this is the fit. I actually made a mistake. I'm wearing my Nike Metcons instead because these are my leg day shoes. My other ones that I showed you are my upper body shoes. So yeah, this is the fit. This is what we'll be roasting and toasting our dump truck in today. So let's go do the pre-workout session. Okay, Sophie's calling me. If she's engaged, I'm gonna freak out.
Matt.
What?
We're moving here.
Oh, you no. What?
Here.
I was gonna say we should do a girls trip.
I miss you.
Okay, well, have the best freaking day. Keep me updated on everything.
But regardless, great time.
Okay, As of right now, I am out of my PE Science creatine, so I had to use a different kind. That is Brett's. So I just use that in here, and then I am using my High Volume by PE Science as well as my Prolific. Coma Caleb with two A's at the end to save. This is the sour peach candy, and I cannot tell you how good this pre-workout tastes. I just need to put ice in my water bottle because so, water, pre-workout, done. You cannot be in the cupboard. Okay, so on the Humpty Dumpty menu, we have 4 times 8 to 10 sets of hip thrusts, 4 times 8 to 10 sets of sumo deads, 3 times 10 Bulgarian split squats with dumbbell RDLs, as well as side lunges and standing calf raises. 3 times 10 for both of those as well. It's gonna be a hefty one. I did have Kang squats in there. I may have taken them out. Mother Nature is just like slightly crushing me right now. I'm gonna be completely honest with you, but it's fine. We're gonna go, we're gonna crush our glutes. It's gonna be a good time. I'll see you in the car. Made it to the gym. I'm not gonna lie, I have the worst abdominal pain on my left side right now. And it's just a very sharp, uncomfy pain. So I'm gonna do what I can, but we're still gonna roast and toast our Humpty Dumpty dump truck. And it's gonna be a good workout. It's fine, it's fine. Sprinkle on some blood, sweat, and tears. Let's get it, let's get it. Okay, that workout kicked my butt and I'm feeling very hangry. I had to drive from the gym to the post office and it's like 11:30, 11:45 right now. So rush hour, like lunchtime traffic, genuinely the worst traffic I've ever seen. I'm going to go make a protein shake. I gotta make some lunch, take a shower real bad. I hope that workout killed you guys as much as it killed me because listen, I know there's a few surprise exercises in there, but I couldn't do you guys dirty. Okay, I was in there, I was like, hey, you know what? I'm feeling better. My weird stomach pains, I don't know if it was like Mother Nature telling me what's up and trying to slap me in the face. By like the middle of the workout, I was like, okay, I'm feeling good, feeling saucy, feeling hot. Let's just bang out a couple more exercises. Conclude the week's worth of workouts because it's been a long week and I'm excited to take 2 days off of the gym. I take 2 rest days. Don't neglect your rest days. Make sure you give yourself grace and give yourself a solid amount of time to rest. I seriously cannot talk. I'm so brain dead right now. I'm so tired. Anyways, next video, I will be doing a Gymshark favorites haul. I'm just waiting for the rest of my stuff to come in. It was technically supposed to be this video, but the Christmas rush, you know? Everybody's ordering stuff, so things are taking 20,000 times longer to get here. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you go follow me on Instagram and TikTok if you wanna join the Pump and Plump Club. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you so much for supporting me and my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Ready? I'll see you in the next video. Mwah! Okay, fine. Okay, I'll see you guys next time.